What's going on, man? I'm Manny. I'm on security detail here. You see a rifle barrel sticking out of the dinosaur's mouth, you got a 50-50 shot at me. Otherwise, it's Boone.
Oh, so you're Manny. I was thinking someone else.
You name it. Anything that comes within 1,000 yards that looks like trouble. Lately, we've been getting ghouls coming from the road to Repcon out to the west. Quite a few last couple days. The big threat is the Legion coming from the east. If they decide to attack with a full force, they'll run us over. But so far, we've been lucky.
I see.
Boone's a sniper, same as me. Used to spot for him when we were enlisted with the NCR. After we got out, I talked him into settling down here. So, here we are. I'd introduce you, but we're not so friendly right now. Me and his wife, we didn't see eye to eye on some things. We had some pretty big arguments. One day, she turns up missing, and he hasn't said a word to me since. Man, you name it. See, I grew up in North Vegas, me and my cousins. We were
sowing
seeds, got in with a gang. I loved it. Then something happened, and I couldn't handle it anymore. So, I enlisted, earned my future, brought down my best friend to share that future with me. And here was this woman, who was too good for it, trying to take him away. So yeah, I didn't see eye to eye with the bitch.
Oh?
Were they tough? I was in the cons, man. It doesn't get any badder. Believe me, when I heard the news, my first thought was, I owe somebody big. I figured Boone would come around after a while. But he hasn't. I'm starting to think that if he doesn't find her, things will never go back to the way they were. Sure, I know him. What do you want with him? Must be something pretty important to be chasing a guy like that.
Oh, trust me, it is.
I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help. There's something I need, too.
Okay.
Novak, it's home for me now. I want that to be for good. I like it here, and I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site. But a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now.
God, my throat.
Well, they gotta go, or this will be a ghost town before. Doesn't matter to me what you do.
Okay.
It'd mean a lot. Man, everybody. That girl didn't have one friend in this whole town. She didn't want any. She wanted to sit in her room all day and make herself miserable, and she went out of her way to be rude.
Really?
She upset a lot of people. You wouldn't have liked her either.
Hmm. Yeah. Oh, that is definitely a mystery. Who kills the big guys of theirs? Wife. Hmm.
Grim wimped out and accepted and fine weather for flying.
It's
like these that make me miss it all.
Sure.
Vertibird pilot. 71 missions and only lost one. I help folks strip down the more complicated bits of salvage. The bits of four.
Okay.
What?
That's it? I didn't get much out of her. Whatever. On to the next one. Honey!
Oh, please don't kill me. I swear I'll have... Wait.
Oh,
you don't
God.
Work for Mr. Bishop, do you?
Mr. Bishop?
Sorry, it's just you look like his type, you know? You got that hard-ass wasteland explorer thing going on.
Really?
Oh, well, that's all just a big misunderstanding, see? Mr. Bishop, well, he owed me a lot of money, and, you know, he's a busy guy, so I sort of figured I'd just take it off his hands.
Right.
I figured it might take him a while to understand his accounting error and cool down a little. Also, I might have, sort of plowed his daughter.
Oh my God.
You do that? Oh, so you have heard of me. You don't know Mr. Bishop. He's not like other bosses. I knew if I didn't get way the hell away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, didn't get much help with this guy. Damn it. Howdy, indeed.
Hey there. Been to the top of the dino yet?
Oh, yeah. That's it?
Prim is a new sheriff. That should keep the powder gangers away.
Oh, trust me. It will. In fact, already does. He pretty much killed all of them. It was amazing. Anyway, seems like you guys are not gonna be help. Need to figure out who the fuck killed her, or should I say sold her out. Those guys are just NPCs, so not gonna get much information of them. Hello.
Hey.
Between you and me, I don't think she studied at an accredited institution.
The fuck? You're just a mercenary. You shouldn't talk so smart.
She hasn't paid me anything yet. Should I be worried?
What can I do for you? Bye.
Sure, bye. Well, some massive bloodstains. That's all I can say. I see. Alright, I guess none of you are special characters, so let's go and check out other people. Hello!
What brings you here?
Boom. That's that sniper fella. Works in the dinosaur, right?
Yes.
I only met them but once or twice. They seemed real happy together. I really ought to get to know them better. They're probably nice folk.
Yes, that's natural, but you didn't tell me anything about his wife.
Oh, we keep to ourselves for the most part. Try not to pry. I think Jeannie Mae gets bothered that we aren't more sociable. But it's just our way. Not that we don't appreciate what she's done, managing this town like she has, but I worry she feels that way anyhow. Not that there ain't others who pry around here. That Nobark was skulking around our yard last week. I thought he was our cow killer. Was about to lash him with our bullwhip till I saw who it was. He's harmless, though. Part of me wishes I could see things like he sees them. All full of mystery. I'm not sure who started it. Wasn't a very nice name. But he took to calling himself by it, so we all had to.
Okay.
I don't even remember what his real name is.
So who is this
anyway,
guy?
I think it comes from that expression that people say when you're crazy, that not all of your dogs are barking. Poor no bark.
Hmm.
Nice of you to visit.
Hey there. You're from out of town, ain't you? Name's Dusty.
Hey, Dusty.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't really know them two as well as I might. I remember she had an edge about her, like she'd rather be someplace else. This kind of life ain't for everyone. That's for darn sure.
Okay, so far it doesn't seem like...
So long.
I was gonna say, so far it doesn't seem like many of them can be the ones. I mean, they all acknowledge she was on edge, but none of them went saying, hey, she's a bitch, she deserves getting killed or something like that. Besides that other lady. Oh yeah. I mean, not the lady, buddy. Anyway, let's go talk with Jenny. Oh, Jenny, oh.
Is everything all right? Awful late to be dropping in unexpected.
I could say that.
How should I put it? I guess you could say she was kind of like a cactus flower. Real pretty to look at, but there was just no getting close to her. She never did take to living here. She liked the big lights and fast living of New Vegas. I got the feeling she was trying to get Boone to leave with her, but I guess she got tired of waiting.
Okay.
Nothing that wouldn't be wrong with any man who loses a wife, I suppose. Poor dear. I know he thinks she was kidnapped, but I'm not so sure she didn't just run off on her own. You could tell she was thinking about it ever since they arrived. Watch out for strangers.
Sure. And she leaves. Let's explore this place. We can find something. Oops. No. Sorry.
Hey there.
Sure, hey there. Okay. So where the hell is this no bar guy? is in that building? God, my throat. See no interest. What the hell? Hello.
Hey.
Nope, not you or you, lady. You guys are just mercenaries. I don't need to talk to you guys. Or should I say don't wanna? Nope. Okay, so where the hell is this guy?
We haven't met yet. You must be new in town. I'm Andy.
What's up?
Carla was a knockout. Whenever Boone walked around with her, he always had this funny grin on his face like he couldn't believe his luck.
Aww.
No, we couldn't. That wasn't the only reason she stuck out, though. That girl never minced words. If she'd had better food or hospitality, she'd let you hear it. Trouble was, she usually had. I don't think she meant it. She really was a sweet girl. I think she just wanted to remind herself that there's still nicer places in this world than Novak. Who could blame her for that?
I see.
Had his wife taken. I don't think he'll ever be the same as he was. Damn shame.
I know.
I told the Rangers up at the station to keep an eye out, but there's just too much ground out there for them to cover. Right now, a whole lot of sitting on my keister and counting cracks in the ceiling. I wouldn't wish it on anybody. On better days, I help keep the peace. Boone and Vargas watch the road. I watch the town. Tell myself I'm doing some good.
Well, at least you're doing something.
Yeah, twice. Actually, the first time, it was more like half my body. Knocked me out of the Rangers. This time, it's mostly just reminded me how useless I've gotten.
Well, you're not useless.
A few years back, we get a tip that some Legion slavers were holed up in this burnout house a few clicks from where we were stationed. We get there and it's deserted. No sign anyone's been there. I mean, nothing. As we're leaving,
I hear something behind me.
Oh, dear.
I turn around, and there's this kid, just skin and bone, and he's looking up at us, and he's scared half to death. Been hiding in a closet. I go to grab him out of there, and I notice he's holding something in his hand. Something metal. He shoves himself back in the closet, and that's when I see the grenade he's left by my feet. They do it a lot, the Legion, using kids. They know we'll hesitate. Anyway, that was the first time.
Second time
I fell down those stairs in front of the motel, just in case I got to thinking I'd put it all behind me.
I mean, so far I don't like either of you guys. NTR or these guys.
Look out for yourself.
I mean, first the Legion uses slaves and the children. And then we have the NTR, don't do shit. They claim to do, but didn't do shit. That's a lot of dinosaurs. Dude, that is a lot of dinosaurs. What the fuck is going on here? Is there a kid here?
To you. You look tired. We're in a little debt. Well, there's Dinky, the town mascot. He's a son. Up the roadways to the west, there's Repcon. There's been some sinister characters out there lately. Other than that, nothing to do.
All right.
Well, but we got our wonderful snow. I just know what I've heard. There's supposed to be some goop ever so often.
You have any luck with the ghouls? Oh, something of... well, I just felt like it was time, you know? I don't blame anybody for it, but it did take something out of it for me. Just...
Okay, so there he is. Yes. Hi.
Who sent you? I ain't talking. They tried to get me to talk before, but I didn't say nothing. And I don't aim to now, by gum.
It's okay. It's okay, Santa Claus.
We'll just see about that. You come any closer, and I'm liable to stick you with my sticking knife. Stick is feeling mighty ornery this day. You sure now? It's kind of hard to hear you.
There.
Okay, just speak up a little. But not so much that they hear you. They got people everywhere, always listening.
Okay, you gotcha. I wanna know what happened to that wife.
Seen shadowy folk come to his room and leave again in the middle of the night. Thought one might have gone in the lobby too for a spell. Could be that person went in to get something. Or used the john, maybe. Mighty interesting either way, you asked me.
Hmm.
I thought those cannibals come to eat us all for sure. So I kept out of sight. But now I know better. More red men come up from the underneath to steal young women with promises of riches and fancy mud mansions with all the latest designer appliances. They covered our lady folk's long hair for wigs, it said, being either bald or balding themselves. Seen? Could... Good idea. There's been things of a disturbing nature going on. Seems every night one of their herd meets a most unnatural death. And always there's holes all over the body. Work of the chupacabra, the livestock vampire, says Nobark. But they don't pay no mind. Too many holes, they say, and there's bullets in them. Well, says Nobark, we got a chupacabra with an automatic weapon.
And that's what they get real quiet. Nice.
Because now they see the predicament we're in.
I like this guy.
I come face to face with the chupacabra himself one night whilst I was investigating whether this gecko was hiding his treasure from me. He was the meanest, ugliest chupacabra you could imagine. Had two heads and fangs down to the ground. Best I could tell anyways, since when he come up to me he was invisible. Had himself a blunderbuss, what would rotate and shoot bullets real fast out of a backpack. Never seen nothing like it. Walked right past me having an argument with somebody. But I only saw one chupacabra, so I guess the other fella had to be invisible too. Only more invisible than the other one.
Interesting.
Folks will tell you that they seen ghouls up near the rocket factory. Sensationalist hooey, cooked up by superstitious yokels, seeing phantoms of their own imagining. Ghosts. Commie ghosts, what don't know they're dead. Hoping to steal our rockets, so they can fly up and paint the moon pink and draw a Lenin face on it. I've seen one of them disappear and reappear before my very eyes. Although, being a scientist, I have to admit I might have just blinked for longer than usual, what with the shock of seeing a commie ghost and so forth.
Wait, I just noticed something. Look at his face, and now look at his... not sure, but underneath his head. That the clothing? It's not having clothes, he's showing his skin. That is his skin. What the hell? You're ripped, but you're green and... What the fuck happened to you?
Because they know I ain't just barking here. What I say is got bite, because it's the truth.
Uh-huh.
Quack doctors can say what they want about all the rad scorpion stings that done pierced my skull. I know what I've seen.
You really need to be careful, though.
If anyone asks, I never spoke.
Sure. Yeah, either that or he's taking a bath in dog poo. Cow poo, either way. So that's interesting. So something is going on here. Definitely suspicious. Of course, I also need the time to deal with this. But the questions are not gonna be easy, seeing there's a certain bitch in here. Alright, I should have more than enough money. Ew.
I hope you're finding everything. Well, let's see. Dusty McBride, Ranger Andy still. They. Well, I think that's a fine idea. I'll give you a good flat rate, and you can stay as well. I'm glad you can stay with us. Your room will be the one up. Here's your...
All right. Now I'll just have to wait until night. When she's sleeping, sneak here, and find somewhere with the evidence as to what exactly happened here. Here we go. She gave me even a teddy bear. That is adorable. Anyway, let's do this.